As you guys know, the header and footer play a vital role in the success of your Shopify website. The header houses your navigation, which should be optimized to drive sales, brand your site, and display your most important pages. While the footer highlights certain value propositions, very specific pages for user attention, important information, calls to action, and links to legal information. In this video, we are going to cover everything you need to know about setting up the header and footer section for your pages when using Foxify layout.
A theme can be considered the backbone of your store, defining its overall look, feel, and functions. We proudly present to you, Zest. A solid base for your online store that is more flexible than flexibility, optimized for conversion and packed with built-in features, and especially dealt with the success of mobile commerce in mind. Your store is generated by clean code, tested and approved by Shopify. Ready to grow your business using the most beloved theme. And get support from our dedicated team. Join the mobile revolution with Zest.
Now, let's get back to customizing header and footer on your Foxify layout. First, we will guide you on how to create a menu for the store's navigation in Foxify. From your Foxify dashboard, click Settings. Then, click Menus. On the Menus page, click Add Menu. On the Add Menu page, enter a menu title to distinguish it from others. If you haven't created the menu item, click Add New Item. Give the menu item a name and link it to a website address for an external website or a link type, such as homepage, collections, products, pages, blogs, articles, or policies. If you want a new tab to be opened when clicking the menu item, then select the Open Link in New Tab checkbox. Click Select to save your menu item, then update the menu. To edit a menu item, click the Edit button beside the name of the item. Then, make the necessary changes to the item name or link. Click Select, then update the menu. You can view and change the display order of menu items on the menus page. Moreover, you can also drag and drop them to create child menu items. To do it, click and hold the handle icon beside the menu item, and then drag the menu item to another position or to the right, under another menu item to create a child item. When you drag a menu item to the right, it nests under the previous or top-level menu item. Then update the menu. To remove a menu item, click Delete beside the menu item you want to remove. Then update the menu. When you delete a menu item that has items nested below it in a drop-down menu, the nested menu items are also removed and the drop-down menu is removed from your menu. Well, that's all for creating menus in Foxify. Let's get back to customizing the Foxify's header and footer. Now, I will create a regular template and choose a pre-built template. Then, give the page a name and select the page layout. Because we would like to use and edit the header and footer of Foxify, so we will set the page layout as the Foxify layout. At first glance, you will see the empty header and the default footer with three columns. Let's start with creating and modifying the header using Foxify. To begin customizing your website's header, start by navigating to the header section, then click the section preset. This setting will give you access to some header presets that you can preview to determine which one best suits your website's aesthetic. Then hit the Select button to apply the preset to your header quickly. If you prefer not to use the preset header options, you have the flexibility to manually create your own header by selecting the plus button next to the header label and adding individual blocks like logo, menu, and add-ons. For a quicker and more efficient setup process, Here, we will use a section preset for our header. Next, in the container field, you can adjust the width of the header to fit with your website. Various options are available, including fixed width, full width, narrow width, extended width, and even custom width, which allows you to set your own width ranging from 800 pixels to 1600 pixels. If you prefer a different layout than the standard one-line design, switching to a two-line layout with the logo positioned on the left may be a more appealing option. You can also enable sticky header to keep the navigation visible on the scroll up, or enable the transparent effect on top of both desktop and mobile. Add a bottom divider to your header if needed. For the mobile layout, you can optionally enable or disable these add-ons such as country or region selector, language selector, and account icon. Then, the Styles tab allows for personalized styling of the header by adjusting the font, font size, color, spacing, layout, and other design elements to align with your brand's aesthetic preferences. Now let's pay attention to the blocks under the header section. In the logo block, users have the option to choose images for the main desktop logo, mobile logo, and logo on the transparent header. This block enables individuals to adjust the size of the logo image by increasing or decreasing the width on desktop within the range of 50 pixels to 300 pixels, and on mobile within the range of 50 pixels to 150 pixels. Move to the menu block. This block lets you display your desired menus along with the logo. You can select a menu you've created in Foxify. To add, remove, or edit menus in Foxify, please check the previous part. The add-ons block offers additional add-ons for the header, including the account link and cart link. Users can customize the icons, adjust their size, show or hide labels, and display cart counts. Additionally, the block includes options for a country/region selector, language selector, and custom code integration. And yeah, that's all for header. Now let's move on to working with footer. Similar to header, you have two ways to create a footer using Foxify. One uses the footer preset for the quick start and one uses grid block with multiple columns corresponding to each content. In the footer section, you can also adjust the width with various options in the container field such as fixed width, full width, narrow width, extended width, and even custom width, which allows you to set your own width ranging from 800 pixels to 1600 pixels. You can also separate the top footer content from the copyright content by enabling the Show Bottom Divider option. Additionally, copyright text can be changed to suit your website. In the grid block, you can choose the layout section for multiple devices. For example, in this preset, the desktop device has three columns, the laptop has two columns, tablet and mobile have only one column. This block also allows you to resize the width of columns in the grid layout customizer for all devices. The column is also resized by dragging the border between two columns. Change the content position setting to determine, control the horizontal and vertical positioning of content containers that are added to the column. You can also adjust the column gap between each column on multiple device views. In each column, you can add whatever content to it to express your website's aesthetic, such as block, heading, text, icon, image, custom code, subscribe form, and so on. You can also mix those elements together to make the complete content. For example, we will add the heading element for each column, then put the menu element below, which will be the menu we've created in Foxify. This menu item will help customers easily navigate and contact the store when they need it. Next, we add the text element to represent a description or a slogan of the brand, with the subscribe form below to get in touch with customers. Moreover, in each element, you can optionally customize it to your preference. And yeah, that's everything for footer. Now, save on the changes. You now know how to customize header and footer in Foxify and use them for your Foxify layout. That's all for now. If you like our video, make sure you give the video a thumbs up and hit subscribe so you won't miss any other future tutorials. Thank you for watching.